Sometimes DNA test results can be confusing. For example, you might find that you and one of your relatives don't share any DNA. There's a couple of reasons for that. Maybe your family tree is actually a little different from what you've been told. But sometimes it's just biology. Specifically, a process called recombination. That's when chromosomes swap DNA. DNA contains the instructions for building your body. At the molecular level, it's shaped like a twisted ladder. Inside your cells, these DNA ladders are arranged in long strands called chromosomes. People usually have 23 pairs of chromosomes. Half of each pair comes from your mother and the other half from your father. But long before egg meets sperm, something interesting happens to your parents' DNA. Inside the cells that become eggs or sperm, chromosomes pair up. Pieces of DNA from one chromosome switch places with pieces of DNA from the other chromosome. This swapping, or recombination of DNA, is important. It injects diversity into the mix, and it ensures that you get just one copy of each chromosome from each parent. Each generation does its own genetic shuffle. So grandma and grandpa each mix up the DNA they inherited from your great-grandparents. Half of that recombined DNA goes to your mom or dad. Then your parents' DNA undergoes similar shuffling before it's passed on to you. To recap, you inherit about 50% of each parent's DNA and about 25% of each grandparent's DNA. But because you don't get a carbon copy of the DNA that your parents inherited from their parents, there's some wiggle room in these numbers. Depending on where the recombination happens on the chromosomes, you could inherit a lot of DNA from your grandfather and very little from your grandmother. So you and your siblings end up with different DNA mixes from your parents, unless you're identical twins. And you and your cousins get different genetic heirlooms from your grandparents. First and second cousins usually share DNA, but because of recombination, about 10% of third cousins won't share any DNA. The same goes for about half of fourth cousins. That doesn't mean you're not related. You still have common family members. And that counts as much or more than having DNA in common.